Om Namah Shivaya. I am Sanchita Roy. Welcome to class 11's biology class. Today I am going to discuss a new chapter, that is animal tissues. In this chapter I am going to discuss about the different types of tissues present in the animals. We have seen in case of the plants there are basically two types of tissues, that is the meristematic tissues and the permanent tissues. And in case of the meristematic tissue, we have seen that there are three types of further divided, and in case of permanent, we have seen that there are simple permanent tissue and the complex. Similarly, in case of the animals also, we can find that there are presence of different types of tissues. The body of a multicellular organism is having different types of tissues, and in this chapter, we are going to have an overview of the different types of tissues which are present in the body of the organism. So in case of the animal tissues, we will see that the animals are basically having four types of tissues, that is the epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscle tissues and the nervous tissues. So in this video I am going to basically discuss about the epithelial tissue. Go into the epithelial tissue. First of all, we have to know that what is a tissue. We have read in the junior classes also that a body of an organism are made up of cells. We know that the cells is known as the structural and the functional unit of an organism. So whenever a group of cells are working together, they are made up of arising from a simple or single origin, and they perform a particular function, we call them as a tissue. So all cells are well organized and coordinated to work in a group. A group of similar cells along with the intercellular substances perform a specific function. Such an organization is called a tissue. The term tissue was introduced by Bichet, and he is known as the father of animal histology. Histology is what? The branch of science that deals with the study of the cells and the tissues is known as histology. Okay? A tissue can also be defined as a group of one or more types of cells having a same origin and specialized for a specific functions along with the intercellular materials. The intercellular materials or the fluids forms the environment of the cell. The cell receives almost all the materials it requires from the intercellular fluid and transfer its waste materials again in this fluid. So whatever necessary things comes through the fluid to the cells, and whatever waste is generated by the tissues or the cells are again released into the fluid. The tissues arises from the undifferentiated cells of the primary germ layers, that is the ectoderm, mesoderm and the endoderm. From here, these three germinal layers, what happens? The cell will undergo the cell differentiation to perform the different types of cells as per their location and their function. The structure of the cells vary according to their function. This variation in cells leads to the formation of the following four types of tissues on the basis of their location and function. What are the different types? Epithelial, connective tissue, muscular tissue and the neural tissue. As I said, in this video, I am going to discuss about the epithelial tissue. What is an epithelial tissue? Epithelial tissue or the epithelium covers both the external and the internal surfaces of the animal body. And the epithelial tissue has a free surface which faces either a body fluid or the outside environment, and thus provides a covering or a lining for some part of the body. Over here you can see these are the examples of epithelial tissue, which is lying on a basement membrane. It is an acellular basement membrane, and below it, it is containing the connective tissue, that is the fluid part, which is responsible for transporting all the necessary things for the cells. At the same time, the waste or the things produced by the cells are released into the connective tissue, which is further transported to the other part of the body of an organism. What are the characteristic features of an epithelial tissue? The epithelial tissues, the cells are compactly arranged. You can see the cells are compactly arranged because their main function is providing protection. So to protect the inner organs from the external environment, whether it is an organ or whether the body of an organism, its main function is to prevent it or protect it from the external environment. So, what is there? The cells are compactly arranged. Intercellular spaces are narrow, 20 to 30 nanometer wide. Adjacent cells are held together by intercellular junctions. We will see that they are joined, the cells, adjacent cells are joined close by certain junctions. The epithelial tissue lies on a thin non-cellular basement membrane. This is a non-cellular basement membrane. Blood vessels are not present in the epithelial tissue. We will not see the presence of the blood vessels. Our skin is a type of epithelial tissue. Can we see the presence of the blood vessels on the epithelial tissue? No, we do not see the presence of the blood vessels on our skin. Materials are exchanged by the diffusion between the epithelial cells and the blood vessels of the connective tissue across the basement membrane. The blood vessels lies below the basement membrane and the transportation and exchange of material takes place by the process of diffusion through the basement membrane. Nerve endings may penetrate the epithelial tissue. In some of the parts, the nerve endings may be seen to penetrate the epithelial tissue. So over here you can see the presence of the different types of epithelial tissue. This is an example of squamous epithelial tissue. There are the cuboidal epithelial tissues, columnar epithelial tissue. So these are the life images of the different types of epithelial tissue. Now, what are the different junctions? Just now in the previous slide, I have discussed about the junctions. As because the cells have to be joined together, they are close by packed. So we can find three types of junctions in between them. They are known as the tight junction, adhered junction, and the gap junctions. So what are these tight junctions are? Tight junctions are what? These are the plasma membranes of the adjacent cells are fused at intervals. At certain intervals, they are fused together. They help to stop substances from leaking across the tissue. Nothing can leak out from here. So that is the reason the plasma membranes are fused in certain regions, so forming a tight junction. Adhering junctions perform cementing function to keep neighboring cells together. They are adhering together to keeping the making a glue like structure over here. Gap junctions facilitates the cells to communicate with each other by connecting the cytoplasm of the adjoining cells for rapid transfer of ions, small molecules and sometimes bigger molecules. There are certain gaps between the two adjacent cells through which the substances can easily pass from one cell to another. So for the easy transportation, the gap junctions can be seen in case of the epithelial tissues. So that basically three types of cell junctions can be seen in the epithelial tissue. They are the tight junction, adhering junctions and the gap junctions. What are the different types of epithelial tissues? As I said, they are simple epithelial tissues and the compound epithelial tissue or the stratified epithelial tissues. The simple epithelial tissues are made up of single layer of cells. They are made up of single layer of cells and they are basically forming the lining for the body cavities, ducts and the tubes. The ducts and the tubes which are present inside our body, they are usually made up of simple epithelial tissue. For example, the walls of the alveoli, they are made up of simple epithelial tissue so that the easy exchange of gases can take place. If it is a multi-layer, if it is a stratified epithelial tissue, it is having more than one layer, then the process of diffusion will become slower. So the alveoli is having a single layer cells. Now next, what are the different types of simple epithelial tissue? They can be further categorized into four types on the basis of the shape and the function. Squamous epithelial tissue, cuboidal epithelial, columnar and ciliated. You can see the squamous epithelial tissue which are present in our buccal cavity. They are irregular shaped, they are having the nucleus centrally located, they are usually flattened and thinner in structure. Single thin layer of flattened cells found in the walls of the blood vessels, air sacs of the lungs. Cuboidal, single layer of cube-like cells found in the ducts of the glands and the tubular parts of the nephron. In the nephrons, we have discussed about in the excretory system, the nephrons are what the unit of the kidney, the excretory unit of the kidneys. So these kidneys, the nephrons are made up of cuboidal epithelial tissue, which is helping in easy absorption and secretion. We have seen in the nephrons, there are different functions. There is absorption of materials are taking place as well as secretion. For easy absorption and secretion, the walls of the nephrons are made up of cuboidal, simple cuboidal epithelial cells. Columnar, single layer of tall and slender cells. Free surface may have microvilli, like this microvilli hair-like structures. Found in the lining of the stomach and the intestine, these villi are actually helping in the increasing the surface area for the absorption of the nutrients absorbed in the small intestine. Ciliated epithelial tissues are what? Columnar or cuboidal cells with the cilia. When these hair-like structures are present on one end of the cuboidal or the epithelial columnar cells, we call them as ciliated columnar or ciliated cuboidal epithelial cells. Move particles of the mucus in the specific directions in the bronchioli, fallopian tubes. These type of ciliated epithelial tissues are present in the walls of the fallopian tubes in the female reproductive system. These fallopian tubes helps in move in bringing the movement of the ovum. We will read it in the later in class 12 that during the process of reproduction, we know that the ova is produced, a secondary oocyte is produced in the ovary. From the ovary, the ova has to be transported to the fallopian tube where the fertilization can take place, and then gradually it is pushed into the uterus. So that movement of the ova is brought about by the ciliated cells present in the walls of the fallopian tubes. Okay. Compound epithelial tissue or the striated. So made up of more than one layer of cells, provide protection against chemical and the mechanical stresses, cover dry surface of the skin, moist cavity, pharynx, inner lining of the ducts of the salivary glands and the pancreatic ducts. So we find that the stratified, the compound epithelial tissues in the places where the cells are having too much of wear and tear. That means they are continuous in movement with some other cells. For example, our skin is what? It is made up of striated epithelial tissue, because many of the dead cells are continuously being removed and the next layer of cells are coming up. If it is made up of a single layered cells, then what will happen? Then it will cause damage to the skin. So the compound epithelial tissue helps or protects our inner tissues from the external environment. The different types of compound cells are what? Depending upon their function, they form the glands. A cell, tissue or organ which secretes some substances is called a gland. The secretions of glands may be protein, in case the pancreas secretes proteinaceous secretions. Lipids, we can see in the adrenal gland secretes the lipids. Mixture of carbohydrates and proteins, the salivary glands are producing the enzymes which are having carbohydrate as well as proteinaceous in nature. Or a mixture of all the three materials, that is carbohydrate, protein and lipid in case of the mammary glands. The glands can be classified into different types based on the site of the secretion, mode of secretion and involvement of single or many cells. So based on the site of the secretion, the glands can be categorized as exocrine glands, endocrine glands and heterocrine glands. Exocrine glands are what? These glands have ducts to pour the secretions to their site of action. These glands releases the secretion where they have to function. Like the exocrine glands are basically secreting the enzymes. Like the gastric glands, then your pancreas is, the liver, they are releasing their enzymes. They often secrete enzymes, and its examples is the salivary gland, which is functioning in the buccal cavity. Intestinal glands, gastric glands, lacrimal or the tear glands present in our eyes. So these are the different types of unicellular and multicellular glandular cells which are present in the body, in the different parts of the body performing different types of functions. The endocrine glands are what? These glands do not have ducts and pour their secretions directly into the blood or the lymph. These glands are also called ductless glands and the secretions are known as hormones. We have discussed it in the coordination, control and coordination chapter where we have discussed about the hormones. The endocrine glands release the secretion into the connective tissue that is in the blood or in the lymph, and from there they are transported to the different organs of the body. We have seen that the hormones, the endocrine glands are the pituitary, thyroid, parathyroid, adrenal. So these are the different types of endocrine glands located in the different parts of our body. Heterocrine glands or the mixocrine glands are what? These glands are partly exocrine and partly endocrine in function, that is the pancreas, kidneys, stomach, gonads, intestine, placenta. They are having both the functions, exocrine as well as endocrine in function. So over here, this is an example of the goblet cells which are present in the walls of the intestine, which are helping in the secretion of the enzymes. Okay. What are the main functions of the epithelial tissues? The main functions of the epithelial tissues are, they are having, providing protects the underlying tissues from the mechanical injury, entry of germs, harmful chemicals and the drying up. It checks the absorption of the harmful or the unnecessary materials. The epithelium of the uriniferous tubules is specialized for the urine excretion. These walls of these cells of the nephron, we have seen, they are working what? They are working in the process of absorption and secretion. We have seen that they are actively taking part in the absorption of the substances like glucose, amino acids, necessary substances which are being produced in the glomerular filtration. They are reabsorbed in the uriniferous, in the proximal convoluted tubule of the uriniferous tubules. And again, secretion is taking place like the sodium, potassium, excess amount. They are again secreted into the nephrons. Okay. The sensory epithelial of the sense organs helps to receive various stimuli from the atmosphere and convey them to the brain. Like the epithelial tissues, the skin, what are they? They are helping in sensing our hot, cold or smooth or rough. So those senses are taken by these sensory organs are taking the sense and they are sending the information to the brain. The epithelium of the alveoli of the lungs brings about the exchange of the gases between the blood and the air. As I said, that the alveoli is having the squamous epithelial tissue which is helping in the exchange of the gases. The pigmented epithelium of the retina darkens the cavity of the eyeball. Epithelium also forms glands that secrete secretions such as mucus, gastric juice and the intestinal juice. The germinal epithelium of the ovaries and the seminiferous tubules of the testes produce ova and the sperms respectively. Epithelium produces exoskeletal structures like scales, feathers, hair, nails, claws, horns and hoofs. They also help in protecting the external internal organs of the body. Ciliated epithelium in the respiratory or the genital tract serves to conduct the mucus and the other fluids in the ducts they line. The respiratory, the nasal cavity is having the ciliated epithelium which is helping in the beating of the air and making the air warmer so that the air can enter properly. So these are the examples of few of the epithelial tissues. This is the ciliated, these are the goblet cells which are responsible for the secretion of the different enzymes or hormones. Then the cube cells, so these are the few of the type of the epithelial cells which are performing different types of functions. So dear students, please make a note of all the important points discussed in the video. Go through your NCERT textbook properly and prepare your notes based on these topics. We will be discussing only the four types of tissues in the case of the animal tissues. Thank you. Om Namah Shivaya.